Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 7 topics to cover, so let's get started. When working with the Gmail API, you can now use annotations to create deal cards in Gmail's Promotions tab. Deal cards are visual summaries of your promotions that are generated by Gmail. They can appear in the Promotions tab and within the email itself, giving your offers maximum visibility. Through the Reports API, you can now get Google Drive activity events when applications prefetch the content of a Drive item. Prefetching in the context of Google Drive is a technique you can use for your application to anticipate and download content from a Drive item before a user explicitly requests or views it. You can now design your chat app to include a carousel. A carousel is a layout that rotates and displays a list of cards in a slideshow format, with buttons navigating to the previous or next carousel card. We've increased per space quota limits for writing messages and reactions with the chat API. When importing data to Google Chat, the per space quota limit for writing messages with spaces.messages.create increases from 60 to 600 per minute. And when writing reactions with spaces.messages.reactions.create, the per space quota limit increases from 60 to 300 per minute. Available through the developer preview program, there are additional chat API methods that support app authentication with administrator approval when called with chat.app authorization scopes. These methods are get a chat space event and list chat space events. Also available through the developer preview program, chat apps can now call some methods in the Google Workspace Events API using app authentication with administrator approval with chat.app authorization scopes. These methods are subscribe to chat space events, update or renew a subscription, and reactivate a subscription. You can now format text with Markdown, including lists and code blocks in your chat apps. Markdown support can help simplify the process to build cards, and is especially critical if you're building AI agents, since the standard output for many LLMs is Markdown. Now, instead of converting the Markdown to HTML, you can pass the entire Markdown to chat, which will handle and render the text correctly. I recently interviewed Taylor Likens, product manager at Lucid Software. Taylor worked on the launch of multiple Google Workspace add-ons to the Google Workspace Marketplace. Check out the video linked on screen to see what tips he shares for building Google Workspace integrations.